Our next speaker is a location-independent entrepreneur who is passionate about community building. He is partner at Coworking Bound School, and he regularly speaks and mentors at various tech, coworking, and startup events. Once a year, he organizes Bound School Nomad Fest, a week-long celebration of the location's independent lifestyle. Matthias is also the managing director of Greenbone Networks Bulgaria, and he is also building a software development team in Bound School that focuses on IT security and vulnerability solutions. Today, Matthias will be telling us more about open source sustainability. So please, your applause for Matthias Zeitler.
Yeah, thank you for welcoming me on the stage. We have quite a few seats left. So if you're further in the back, we have some good seats. I will talk about today how Greenbone Networks is using open source in its business strategy. And to give you a little bit of an idea what this presentation will be about. So we are in the IT security space, so we'll give a quick overview to you what's going on in IT security and how we play in that industry. I will give you a quick idea about what Greenbone is all about, and then how we chose to use open source as our business strategy. And I hope we will have a lively discussion afterwards about open source and business strategies in general. Greenbone, I don't know if any one of you have used Greenbone or Greenbone products before. Our open source product is called OpenVAS. It's a vulnerability scanner for IT security. And we are the leading European company that is providing these type of solutions. It's used worldwide. We have Enterprise Edition that's used by global 500 companies. But we also have about 50,000 installations in the field in our Community Edition, which means there's a broad range of users all over the world that is using OpenVAS to scan for IT vulnerability solutions. When you look into the media, IT security is something that's going on every single day. There's many data breaches. There have been some high-profile data breaches here in Bulgaria as well, but it happens to companies all over the world that either their accounts are hacked, their customer data is released, their source code goes out in the open, their movies are released on all kind of pirating and torrenting sites. So IT security is something that is very serious, and no large companies or no small company wants to be in the news that their customer data is now out in the open. When you look at IT security incidents, it's becoming more and more expensive every year. So some of this data a little bit older. So in 2019, in the US alone, there was an estimated about $3.5 billion in damages. Resulted from IT security incidents. But if you just look in the news last week, we had the Polygon network was hacked for $600 million alone. So IT security and vulnerabilities is really something that's happening every single day, and it's affecting a lot of people and it's creating a lot of damages. When a lot of people think about IT security and hackers. They think about these guys from the movies, and they're somewhere in an underground facility, and they're all dressed up, and they're doing crazy stuff. And they are hacking into the Iranian government to bomb their nuclear program. But most of this is really a myth. So this is not how most IT security incidents happen. Most likely, the company was just targeted by a random attack. So there's a lot of IT security tools, penetration testing frameworks, script kiddies that can scan IT systems in very large range and can easily find out if there's some software running that has known vulnerabilities. And this is the biggest risk. So it's not like you have to be a specific target and there's some bad Russian or Ukrainian hackers that are moving in to your small grocery store and they want to crack your bank account. This is not how what's happening. What's happening is there's millions and millions of people around the world that are running these automated tests, and they find systems that are vulnerable. And this is exactly where we play. So at Greenbone, our mission is to create safety, IT safety and security for our customers. And we do this mostly by discovering vulnerabilities before the bad guys can discover these vulnerabilities. So our tools are deployed in company networks, and they scan systems for known vulnerabilities. There's lots and lots of vulnerabilities. So there's like a lot of vendors that disclose when they have IT issues, IT security issues. And once we are aware of something like this, we create an automated test and we integrate it in our solution. And then all our users are automatically notified if some of their systems have a known vulnerability. And of course, there's reporting around it. We provide professional service around it. But basically, what we do is we check for vulnerabilities. To give you an idea what this looks like, so it's a dashboard type of solution that collects all this information. A little bit of a challenge, of course, is there's many, many, many vulnerabilities if you have lots of systems and you need to figure out what is really important to fix and what is less critical. And our tools help you to identify the vulnerabilities that could really become a problem in the future. To take a step back, now that you know what we actually do, I want to tell you a little bit why we do it and how we do it. So when Greenbone was created about 10 years ago, our founders were strong believers in free software. And free software for us, and probably also for the rest of the world, means that you have the freedom that you can run and use the software for any purpose that you want to use it for. So we are not limiting the use of our software, and free software should not limit the use of software. It should allow you to understand what the software is doing, and you should also be able to change the software. So this means that you need to have access to the source code, but often it's not only the source code, but also the test framework, for example, the documentation, everything that's related to the program should be available so that you are able to adapt it and change it for your use cases. Of course, the thing with free software is also you should be able to redistribute it. I think this is super important. And this is also how our software works. Our Open VAS scanner is free software, and we have people distributing it and redistributing it. Now, of course, we are companies. So what's also important for us is that we must be able to do all these things without giving away everything, right? So there still needs to be something left over. And we have some parts of our solution, namely this feed with all the vulnerabilities, where we separate between what's community-driven and what's open source, and what is something that is our enterprise product. And there's many, many other companies that have a similar approach. So when you look at GitHub, for example, you'll find out that about over 70% of all Fortune 60 companies are using open source in some way or form. And this also means that nearly all the software and all the service that we are using is at least in some part based on open source. So it's really an important business aspect as well. It's not just for hobbyists, but it's really big businesses are very interested in open source. And you probably already know this, but I wanted to give you a quick overview for those people that may be new to free software, new to open source, to have them understand what we are talking about. Greenbone, as I mentioned, so our founders are big proponents of open source software. So when they started the companies 10 years ago, they decided very specifically that it should be based on open source. And because we are in this IT security industry where it's really important that customers also understand what we do to their systems, this is a major advantage because our customers can actually see what code we run on their systems. They can audit this code. They can decide if they want to tailor it to their requirements. And this is a major advantage compared to a closed solution where maybe you just press a start button and then you don't know what's really happening. So for us, open source is not just like a marketing label. For us, open source is really the core of our business. To give you an idea about the specific advantages, one advantage is transparency. So all our code is on GitHub. People can see and review this code. People can also see like how many tests we have. They can comment on the bugs. They can see if there's any issues with the code. And they can have independent experts reviewing our code base. And of course, this builds a lot of trust for them and makes it very reliable when they use it in their enterprise environments. Another big advantage of open source is sustainability. So I don't know if you know that, but as a company, that's still in business, that was founded 1400 years ago. It's a construction company from Japan. And of course, a lot of the systems that they were using over the last 14 centuries, the suppliers are gone by now. With open source, this really can't happen, because with open source, the product is out in the open. Even if your supplier would go out of business, you're still free to continue to use the product, to continue to improve the product, to maintain the product, maybe find some other people to restart development on an open source product, and so on. And of course, for enterprise customers, this is super important, because a lot of companies are in business for longer periods of time. Rolling out a new system into an enterprise environment is always a lot of work. So having the risk that maybe in a few years this tool is no longer supported is not really acceptable. So people prefer to know that the product is independent of the company. Another huge advantage of open source, and also an advantage in our industry, is availability. So there's a fun website called Killed by Google, and has over 240 products that Google has discontinued. And if you chose to use one of these products, then you're kind of left out in the rain, because whatever solution you were building your business on is gone now. There's another website called Review Signals that is reviewing WordPress hosting companies. And there are thousands and thousands of these WordPress hosting companies. And WordPress, of course, is open source. So if one of these hosters would decide to discontinue WordPress hosting, that's not a big problem, because there's many, many other companies that will step in. And this is one of the major advantages of open source, is this availability that's independent from the original creator of the software. But of course, commercial open source also has some challenges. Because obviously, how do you make money if the product is free? Right. So at Greenbone, we have found a solution for this, and many other open source companies have found a solution for this as well. Our solution is, on the one hand, our core product is a piece of hardware. So it's a rack-based appliance that companies just install into their network, and they turn it on and it runs. So it's not a, it's an open source solution, is something that people can install on different hardware. But our customers buy our appliances. They don't have to deal with the setup. They don't have to deal with the configuration. They know that the hardware is hardened and specifically built for our vulnerability scanner. So it's very, very difficult to access it by people that shouldn't access it. And of course, for these hardware installations, they can be on-premise, which means companies have it totally inside their network and they control the whole environment. We also have a software as a service solution, which is more of a monthly subscription for what we call a virtual appliance. So this is for companies that are at a smaller scale, that maybe don't have the same requirements like IBM or HP, and that want to have a cloud-based solution. And we have something like this as well. Again, we take care of the installation and the configuration for the customer, and the customers are paying us a monthly fee. In addition, we have the core of our product is this vulnerability scanner that is based on a security feed. We have a community security feed that has 10,000 of vulnerability. I think the current count is about 90,000. But we have also some vulnerabilities that we only provide in our enterprise feed, and this is mostly for enterprise products. So we believe that companies that can install, for example, a closed source solution like SAP should also pay for the SAP-related security vulnerability analysis. So we are selling this enterprise feed as a subscription as well. And of course, we have a professional services team that will help customers with installation support and maintenance. And as you can see, there's quite a lot of opportunities to make revenue, even with an open source software product. And I think this is really beautiful, and we love this. So on the one hand, we can give back to the community, we can collaborate with independent developers and security researchers on our products. But on the other hand, we also have something that customers are willing to pay for. Again, a quick overview. So our products is, we have the security tests and policies that contain all the vulnerabilities. We have virtual solutions, software as a service based subscriptions for people that don't want to install hardware. And then, of course, we have our hardware appliances for the larger installations. And the selling the hardware is not only a good business model, but it's also a requirement. So we have some customers that have hundreds and hundreds of thousands of different IP addresses in their networks. And then, of course, scanning those for about 100,000 vulnerabilities each can take a very, very long time. So our hardware is not only one box, but we also deploy smaller boxes in subnetworks so that really companies have an up-to-date view on what's going on in their network, even if they have huge and highly scaled networks. Greenbone is originally a German company. We have just opened business here about a few months ago. We want to build a software development team in Bulgaria. I'm based in Bansko, close to the mountains, and I love the mountains. So, of course, we also want to build a software development team there, but all our jobs are remote. So we have a team that's distributed worldwide. We have a large operation in various German cities. We have an office in the UK, and now we're in Bulgaria. And of course, a lot of the work that is done by people sitting in different locations. So even before this pandemic, we were, I think, more remote than most companies. And we also fully embraced this remote work style. And with this, I would like to open this up a little bit to discussions to see how you are using open source in your business or how you have encountered open source business challenges and in turn is more into a discussion than just into a presentation. Anyone in the room wants to start? Don't be shy. No questions about open source business models? Has anyone used OpenVAS before? A little bit. How do you like it?
I'm sorry, I'm shouting out. Yeah, I'm more interested in vulnerabilities and dependencies and not that much in network vulnerabilities. So, yeah, that's my primary focus.
I mean, the thing that we have found, so we don't have the silver bullet for IT security, right? So IT security is the whole process and an ecosystem of different things you need to do to protect your network. And I think we can provide one tool, but this is also, there's a lot of other tools and they're also open source, right? So most of the firewalls are open source, for example. A lot of the network components are based on open source technology. And I think in security, open source is really super important because then you can actually see what's going on. Any other questions or feedback? Maybe. I mean, marketing is basically telling people about our offering, right? And being able to tell people that we have an open source product, I think is very often a purchase decision. It's not the only reason why people buy us or why they choose us over the competition, but I think it's a very important aspect. And I also don't think that all the customers actually look into our code. So, but it's just knowing that if they wanted, they could, is a really big advantage.
Do we have any more questions? All right. Well, if you want to ask your questions, you can do it after now the session at the speaker's corner. So thank you very much for the interesting presentation.
Yeah, thank you very much, everyone, for coming.